specialist. Today, we're really happy to have Fabio Rossi, director of Rossi & Rossi, join us today. He specializes in Himalayan classical art and early textiles. Welcome. So, Fabio, can you tell us a bit about yourself and your gallery?
Certainly. First, very nice to meet you in this remote way, but it's a good way to get keep in touch. So the gallery was Rossi & Rossi was founded by my mother. She started working with Indian and Himalayan art in the early 70s, so about 50 years ago. And I joined her in 1987, so over 30 years ago. So in fact, we celebrated our 30th anniversary in a few years ago. This is a photo of me and my mother, our photo. And so we specialize in Indian and Himalayan art and also early Chinese text. As you said, the gallery was based in London for 30 years. We still have offices there, but since 2011, I live in Hong Kong and I opened my current space in 2013.
Well, thank you. So which piece will you be sharing with us today?
I'd like to share with you one of the most extraordinary objects I've had the pleasure to handle in all my career. Let me just put that book. This is an object that comes from Mongolia, and it's lotus mandalas. Lotus mandalas are religious objects, and they're quite not uncommon, but what makes this very unique is the mechanism of the object itself, which I will show in a second. As far as we know, and we have also had a curator of the past with me, Beijing, writing a long essay for us. There are only two examples like these in the world. One is in the British Museum, and it's quite small in terms of size. This is the biggest two. And this was made in Mongolia in the 17th century, and it's attributed to the atelier of Zanabazar. Zanabazar was a famous artist and head of the church, painter, sculptor, lived a very long life. He was also an engineer, interested in that, so he built bridges and all that. And he was so famous and so good that he was invited by the country to the court in Beijing. He started an atelier and a number of pieces made in Beijing, which can be attributed to his atelier all the time. This piece was, as I said, made in the late 17th century. What is unique about it, as it's first, it's extremely beautiful object, of course, but it's really the mechanism of how you open the lotus mandalas. So you have to lift this circle of auspicious symbol. You use your hands, you have to use a little bit of force. And by using that force, obviously the central figure of Chakrasambhava, the deity, emerges. This is something that, as I say, only two have this way, this mechanism. Obviously, something that only an engineer could have somehow devised. All the other lotus mandala, they tend to have like a little cap. Actually, one can be in the manually bring the cap, leaves together. This is, as I say, you just use this way of causing it. Voila, that's it. It's in perfect condition. Gilt bronze with so it's copper alloy with gilding. Even the base is still sealed, the original seal, typical modern type of seal. So this is something that really we're excited to have, and we will be showing as a finalization on top of that. We sold this originally, my mother and I sold it in 2002. It's published in our anniversary book. We had found it in a private collection in Europe and sold it to another private. We're very privileged to be a collector now as designer to entrust it to us to sell it. And so we hope that we can find a great home for it.
Okay, thank you so much for sharing with us today. And we hope to see you soon. And thank you for joining us.
It's been a pleasure, always a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you.
Thank you. We'll see you next time.
See you next time. Bye bye.